If you have the Versions and History panel open while working, you'll notice something new. When other people are in the documents at the same time, you'll see their design changes in real time. Any changes to the document will show up here instantly, such as adding or deleting branches, creating versions or releases, and even automatic versions created by a change to a linked document that was updated from a top-level assembly. In a fast-moving agile development environment, real-time versions and history keeps you up to date with all activity. So, some design changes have been made to the chuck, so let's merge them into main. Two new filters have also been added to the versions and history panel. One to hide those automatic versions to make the list smaller and easier to read, and another to show merge lines. These lines show where a merge has taken place, either from a version or from a workspace, and the exact change or point in time where the merge took place, and also where it came from, are called out to make it easier to understand the timeline. Finally, the branch filter can now also show the current branch and all its parent branches. In highly collaborative product design, real-time updates and merge lines make the process much easier, only in Onshape. When new features are added to Onshape every 3 weeks, a new version of the feature library is required. If a branch references an older version of the library, it must be updated before it can be merged. This process has been completely reworked to be more efficient and, in many cases, unnecessary. If there are no differences between the source and target branch, a message states that everything is up to date and the merge button is disabled. This can happen if the source branch was created from the target branch and no further edits were made. If you want to use this to selectively replace some tabs in the target branch, you can, and no update is required. This is because a workspace can now contain tabs referencing different versions of the feature library. If there are differences between branches, an update can still be avoided if you choose the right merge strategy. A version library mismatch is now only an issue if you want to merge changes made to the same part studio in different branches. Using the replace option simply overwrites all the changes in the target branch with that of the source, so no update is required and the merge can go ahead. Notice that changes to an assembly can be merged no problem. If you do want to combine changes made to a part studio, the merge cannot go ahead until the document has been updated, and for that to happen, it must be closed completely. So Onshape will check if the document is open in other windows, either on this device or another, and if anyone else has the document open, regardless of which branch they may be working in. Once the check confirms that everyone is out, the document can close and the update can proceed as usual. Bridging curves can now maintain G3 continuity, also known as acceleration or flow, with adjacent curves and surfaces. Setting this option adds a third manipulator that can be used to add more definition to the curve. The effect of G3 can be seen best by using the measure tool to show the curvature change across the boundary. With G1 continuity or tangency, the curvature combs are aligned, but the magnitude is different. For G2, or curvature continuity, the curvature combs are aligned and have equal magnitude, but there is a clear change in direction. With G3 continuity, you can see how the rate of change of curvature is smooth as one feature flows into the other. This not only creates super smooth curves, but also lays the foundation for subsequent curves and surfaces to create higher quality geometry. The loft feature now has a thin option. The inputs are identical to a surface loft, but now you can enter a thickness on one or both sides of the surface, so you don't need to add a thicken feature as a second operation. This feature goes one step further, as the ends can be trimmed to align with the profiles. Onshape now enables you to add colour to curves. Following on from the recent addition of sketch colours, any curves in your part studio will now be listed in the Appearance panel, and you can edit or configure each curve by right-clicking, edit the color by double-clicking, or edit multiple curves at once by right-clicking in the Graphics area and selecting Edit Appearance for Curves. Adding color makes it easier to visually distinguish between different sets of curves, which is especially useful when creating complex surface models or custom features like the excellent Ray Tracer, here modified to show refracted and reflected rays in different colors. Composite parts containing curves can now also be assigned an appearance to add more definition and clarity wherever they're used, in part studios or assemblies. When inserting a part or subassembly into an assembly, clicking the green check mark without clicking in the graphics area will place its origin at the assembly origin. Unless you fix or group that object, it is free to move, and if it is moved, there isn't an easy way to get it back, especially if the geometry has no obvious reference that can be used for a mate connector. Right-clicking a part on screen or from the instance list now has an option to add mate connector to instance origin. This creates an assembly mate connector referencing the part origin, which can then be used to fasten it to the assembly origin or anywhere else. You could have added that mate connector to the part studio where the part came from, but what if the inserted object has already been released? You don't want to re-release something just to add a mate connector, so this new option addresses that. For subassemblies, you can select a part contained within it, or to get the origin of the subassembly itself, select it from the instance list. This simple addition can make assembly work so much easier. The inspection table in drawings now supports cross-highlighting to make it easy to see which annotation is selected. Then a simple right-click adds the item number. This works both ways, so you can select a dimension on screen, then add the item number from the table without having to bring up the inspection item dialog. Multi-selecting a number of rows highlights them all on screen, and selecting them on the drawing highlights them in the table. Navigating an inspection table has never been so easy.
Onshape version 1.81 will be coming to you with the all-new Render Studio. Gone is the scene manager. No more editing and then saving scenes. The Render Studio tab is the scene, so each incremental change is stored in the same manner as those changes in Onshape itself. Render Studio is integrated in the same manner as part studios, assemblies, and drawings. If you need to restore to an earlier point in the version history, scroll through the change history, select the point in history that you want, and then restore it to the main branch. This makes Render Studio much more intuitive for new users. On-demand tessellation means that there is no longer a need to set scene tessellation globally. When setting up a scene, if there are objects which appear faceted, those objects can be selected, and then a finer level of tessellation can be set. Additionally, these settings are saved with part instances. Change the tessellation for one component in an array, and they all update to follow suit. Render Studio now supports local and linked document versions. Updated documents are indicated with the same icon that you are used to seeing with assemblies and drawings, and changes are processed using the Reference Manager. This is the same workflow you are used to elsewhere in Onshape and means you have the option of updating to either the latest or specific version of the linked document. Render Studio's appearance library has undergone what can only be called an organizational overhaul. It is now significantly more ordered, with a greater number of categories and subcategories, making it easier to find the appearance you're looking for when scrolling through the various appearance types. Appearance functions, such as bump maps, decals, etc., are now all located in a single category, further cleaning up the library. As before, the fastest way to find a specific appearance is to use the search tool, and applying one, once found, has never been easier, as dynamic highlighting makes it quickly apparent what components are selected. Appearance editing has also been improved, with the panel options streamlined to make editing more straightforward. Render Studio's SafeFrame eliminates all guesswork from setting up production renders. Once the dimensions and size of the render are selected, a frame is indicated which shows exactly what will be in the image. This is a dynamic display, which means that changes can be made to the overall orientation of the objects in the scene. Pans, zooms, and rotations are all supported. Once this scene manipulation is done, the results can be saved to a named view, enabling you to experiment with different appearances, environments, or camera changes while maintaining the same image framing. This is a big step forward and one we feel you'll find extremely useful. Finally, Onshape's exploded views are now fully implemented and supported in Render Studio. Once set up in the assembly environment, exploded views are accessible from the right-click menu when an assembly which has one saved is selected in the browser. All of the same Render Studio processes are supported in this view mode.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.